San Francisco originally, and but ethnically, my parents are from Nicaragua.
Okay. And what brought you to Los Angeles? How did you get here? What brought you?
Movies, man, movies. I love movies, and I always wanted to be in them. So this is my third attempt at coming out here, and third time's a charm, they say, right? So I came out here in 2008, and just been grinding ever since. So yeah, I don't know. All right, well, what brought me out to LA is movies, obviously, but I remember when I wanted to become an actor. I was 11 years old. I remember there was movie phone. There wasn't like YouTube where you could look at trailers or anything, but there was movie phone where you call and it's like, hello, welcome to movie phone. So I used to call it all the time, and you could listen to the trailer, because Leonardo DiCaprio was like my favorite actor from Growing Pains. I just thought he was cool, you know, like he was the cool homeless character. And then he started doing movies, and then Baz Luhrmann's Romeo and Juliet was coming out. And there's a part in the trailer, it's in the movie, but in the trailer, where he screams Juliet to the top of his lungs, and I remember I was like, whoa, that's intense, man. And it gave me like this, I don't know, like just intense, crazy feeling in my gut. And I was just like, I'm gonna do that, man. I wanna make people feel like that. So that's, and then here I am 20 years later, you know?
Okay, and you started in the Bay Area. And,
yeah.
You said this is, you made multiple attempts at coming down here.
I've come out here two other times prior to this time. I came out here when I was about 19 with $300 in my pocket and hopes and dreams, you know? And I convinced my buddy to come with me. I was like, man, you know, we're not doing nothing out here, man. We could just go to LA. Arnold Schwarzenegger did it with $20 in his pocket and he didn't even speak English. So we Greyhounded it and we came out to Hollywood, which the Hollywood Greyhound is no longer there. It's like, there's a big parking lot. But it was my first time and I'm looking at Hollywood like, yo, man, look at the Eddie Murphy, Sylvester Stallone, I'm looking at all the stars. And we stayed in this Roach Motel. We got it for like a week. And we were like, we're going to get a job. We'll get a bus tables or whatever. But that did not pan out. And then my mom sent me some money. She was like, oh, don't worry about your friend. Get a room for rent. Just focus on yourself. I was like, all right, no problem. But I bought a car. I bought a bucket car. And I told my buddy, I was like, look, man, we'll sleep in the car. Then when we get auditions, we'll have transportation. Not thinking of gas and all that stuff, right? And then... that lasted about another week, and then my friend gave up, and he's like, I'm out of here, man. I don't know how he came up with money, but he mouthpieced somebody, and they bought him a ticket to go back home when we were at the Greyhound station. He's crying, like, I'm staying, man. He's like, yeah, I know, man, you're going to make it. I lasted like another week and drove back up to San Francisco. That was attempt number one. And then I tried again with a couple years later with a girlfriend at the time. But, life got in the way and brought me back. And then ultimately, my third time is this time, you know? And I like saved money and I was just came out here, found an apartment and just did it properly. And you know, and it's just, I just didn't want to give up no matter what, you know? It was always like, that's what I'm gonna do. I'm a high school dropout, I got no backup plan. This is it.
Sure. So let's fast forward a little bit. You're here for the third time and yeah. You're here. So, can you tell us about the first time you stepped in front of the camera on a professional level and how that felt?
I guess Warrior with shout out Gavin O'Connor, man. He's been super supportive since I met him. I got Tap Heart lead into that and. My first time speaking on the film, and they flew me out to Pittsburgh. It was surreal. I felt like, wow, man, this is movie business, you know? It was validating, you know? It made everything like, wow, just all the times that I've came out here. And it was just, you know, a small role, but it just reminded me like, wow, man, this is why you came out here for. So it was just the beginning of, it was a taste. And it just had me hungry.
Cool.